Hello, I'm Edgar Medina, manager of the Power Systems Experience Center in Houston, and today I'm with Mitch McClain, product manager for low voltage air circuit breakers.
Thanks for having me, Edgar. You have a beautiful facility here.
So Mitch, what are we standing in front of?
So this is our new Magnum PXR circuit breaker. Many of you are probably thinking this looks a lot like our Magnum DS circuit breaker, and you're right. It's very similar from a construction standpoint, but it has our new Power Xpert Release, or PXR, trip unit integrated into the breaker. What's special is more advanced metering capability and communication capabilities. And the coolest part is Eaton now has a consistent trip unit platform across our entire low voltage circuit breaker portfolio.
So, is this the same trip unit platform as Power Defense molded case circuit breakers?
Yep, it's the same PXR trip unit platform that you'll find in Power Defense molded case circuit breakers and our Series NRX breakers. Right now in Magnum, we offer a PXR 20 and a PXR 25. PXR 25 comes standard with Modbus and ARMS, our arc flash reduction maintenance switch, whereas on PXR 20, it's optional. This is available to our OEMs and is also available in our switchboards and switch gear that come out of our different satellites in Asheville. And we started shipping to customers in early 2022.
So the Magnum PXR has been around for a little bit. So what's the deal with the blue piece at the bottom of the breaker?
Well, Edgar, I'm really glad you asked about it because I'm really excited to talk about it. So the blue fascia down here by the levering door is to show that the Magnum PXR breaker is equipped with our motorized remote racking device, which is also known as MR2.
MR2, I feel like I've heard something like this before.
Well, if you're familiar with our Eaton medium voltage switchgear and breakers, you probably have. MR2 has been available on medium voltage gear for quite some time now.
Got it. So how does this work with the Magnum?
The MR2 is integrated into the circuit breaker, so it's already on board. There's a motor in there, and that motor is controlled by what we're calling a controller that's mounted on the side of the cell or cassette, or it's in the wire way of the switch gear. A user can remotely rack a breaker in and out of the cell, all the way from connect to disconnect or disconnect to connect, with a pendant like I have here, or they can use discrete controls, or they can do it via Modbus communications.
So I've noticed that the pendant looks the same as the medium voltage MR2 pendant.
Good eyes, Edgar. That's because it is. We use the same exact controller between Magnum and medium voltage. If a user already has medium voltage equipment with MR2 and they already have a pendant, they don't need to buy another pendant if they have low voltage switch gear with Magnum MR2 installed.
So you specifically only said Magnum PXR. Is this not available on the older Magnum DS?
MR2 is only available on Magnum PXR. The main reason for this is because of the secondaries that we have on Magnum PXR compared to what they're like on Magnum DS. On the Magnum PXR secondaries, we have a little piece that sticks out a little bit further that we're calling tertiary connections. The tertiary connection is how we get control and power to the motor while keeping the breaker fully in the disconnect position.
That makes sense. Okay, let's change gears here a little bit. For context, how would an operator typically rack a breaker in and out of its cell?
So typically, an operator would have a 3/8 inch drive and a ratchet. He would open the gate right here, insert that into the screw shaft on the breaker, and then the operator would physically rack the breaker in with that ratchet all the way from disconnect to test, do whatever they need to do with testing as far as opening, closing the breaker, making sure that any of the accessories are working properly. Open the breaker and then move it all the way back to the connect position, then close it and walk away. Another option that we have is a device that we have where it sits on the front of the breaker. It's the MRR. That goes on the front of the breaker, but an operator still has to enter that arc flash boundary in order to put that device on the front of the breaker. And you'd have to do that for every single breaker and remove it, put it back on, remove it, put it back on for any time you're wanting to rack that breaker in and out. With the MR2, now that's completely eliminated because it's already on board the breaker, and all an operator has to do is either with discrete controls, a pendant, or Modbus communications, they can rack the breaker in and out completely remotely and outside that arc flash boundary.
So what's the benefit of having the MR2 on the breaker?
Great question. The main benefit is safety for the operator. By having the MR2, an operator never has to get in front of the breaker, which means they never have to get within the arc flash boundary of the gear when they're racking a breaker in or out of the cell. In the typical ways I just went through, in each of those instances, an operator would be required to breach the arc flash boundary.
I think I'm ready to see the breaker with MR2 in action.
All right. So first, the breaker is already in the disconnect position. The breaker is open. So those are two conditions that we have to even start. Most important being that the breaker is open. If the breaker is closed, it's not going to rack in or out because we obviously wouldn't want it to do that. And just like with our standard breaker, if it's closed, the gate down here won't even open. So all I'm going to do is with the pendant, push enable, and then I'm going to move to test position by pushing the test button. So already you can hear the motor is already turning, and the breaker, if you watch, is slowly going back into the cell. We can also see on the indication down here that the breaker is slowly moving into the test position based on this indication. And right now we have the charging motor is activating, so the spring mechanism is fully charged, so it's ready to close when we eventually get it back into the connect position. So now we're already in test, and now I'm going to move it to the connect position. So it's moving back. Again, we can see that it's moving in here. There's interlocks, so if this gate were to open and someone was trying to stop the racking with a wrench or anything like that, the entire motor would shut off. That's one of the safety features that we have in there. You can see as the breaker's moving back, it's starting to get onto the stabs, and we are almost there. You may not have noticed, but when it got to the test position, that's when the trip unit turned on. Yeah, that's basically the entire operation from racking from disconnect all the way to connect.
So now that the breaker is in the cell, what kind of safety interlocks are there?
All the safety interlocks from UL 1066 Annex D remain intact. For example, right now the breaker is closed. I cannot use the MR2 to move the breaker or rack the breaker. This is just like how I cannot lift the levering mechanism door on a standard Magnum. In addition, if the breaker is open and this levering door is open, I cannot use the MR2 to electrically rack the breaker out of the cell or into the cell. I can also lock out the ability to manually rack the breaker in and out, and I can also completely lock out, tag out with the breaker with a padlock or padlockable hasp.
Excellent. So tell me more about the actual motorized racking device. What kind of motor is it? What is the motor protected by? What happens when the motor fails?
Sure thing. To start, it's a small 120 volt AC motor and gear system that turns the levering shaft and claw shaft at the bottom of the breaker. We have two different motor options. One is for our single frame breakers like I have here. The other is for our double frame breakers, which are 4,000 to 6,000 amps.
Oh, awesome. So this goes all the way up to 6,000 amps. Now, what about protecting the motor on the actual device?
We have multiple protection functions built into the controller logic to prevent the motor from overheating or burning up or anything like that. One of the protections monitors the torque on the motor. If the torque exceeds the upper limits, the motor shuts off and you get an error code that's given to you, the operator. If this is the case, it's likely there's an obstruction in the cell that the breaker is running into. An operator could have left a wrench in there, something like that. Another protection is a timeout. The device isn't designed to be racked in and out constantly over and over and over again in a short period of time. So after a certain amount of times being racked in and out within a certain time window, the MR2 will shut off to protect that motor.
So what does a customer have to do if they have a Magnum PXR breaker, but they want to get the MR2 installed? Are there retrofit kits available?
We have retrofit kits available for any Magnum PXR breaker. A customer would just need the MR2 device and a controller. The pendant is only needed if a customer doesn't already have one for their medium voltage gear and if they don't plan on using Modbus or discrete controls to provide a signal to the controller. Eaton's Magnum PXR breakers with integral motorized remote racking, also known as MR2, helps mitigate electrical arc flash exposure by allowing the operator to work from outside the arc flash boundary. To learn more about the Magnum PXR with MR2, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power Systems Experience Centers today.